example, if you go to an ICD-9 code and you look up what anemia is, you'll find 37 different codes for anemia. Well, clearly, if you're trying to communicate the fact that a patient has anemia, you can't develop 37 codes that then get sent out to systems for the other system to understand them. So there has to be some harmonization, bring together of those standards in one place to allow people to have one standard that they can actually work against, and that's what the HITSB work works on. So it's not only the data interchange, but it's also the other clinical vocabularies. And they work to include the HIT vendors as well as the medical device vendors so that they can be part of setting those types of standards. And then to make sure that they work, they utilize use cases, which is an example case of, okay, here's a clinical case, here's what we want, how we want information to be transferred. Let's take these standards and see if they work within that particular environment. It's kind of like a simulation. What does CCHIT do? Well, we wanted to set up a group, an organization within the US that would say, let's go to stakeholders, vendors, as well as users, and it certifies the electronic health records and their networks and to ensure that there's that level of interoperability. The SDOs are standards development organizations, which there are many of. HITSB also works with them. And CCHIT works with HITSB to understand those standards. Again, in this situation, CCHIT is an independent, non-government entity. What's HIM's vision for change? Well, interestingly, in December, after the presidential election, we brought together in HIMS a variety of our committees, particularly advocacy committee, but others, and said, what do we need to do for a call to action to the new administration? And here are some of the things that we came up with that really bubbled up from our volunteers up to our higher level staff, actually went to our board of directors, which we reviewed back in December, and then became part of an announcement as part of a press conference. We believe that health information technology should be used for reforming healthcare to address a couple of issues. One, it needs to improve quality, reduce costs, and enhance safety. And all of those three things are related. The use of EMRs, personal health records, and e-prescribing to achieve those goals, and none of this can happen without facilitating interoperability. So this was our message to the new administration. The immediate challenge is still in several areas. You need leadership. Someone within the government needs to say, this is what we are going to try to accomplish, and we're going to bring people together to accomplish that. There needs to be interoperability. We can't have separate systems not speaking to each other. We can't have fiefdoms of organizations not willing to share information. I'm involved in an organization called the Global Health Alliance, and what we are trying to do is we're a not-for-profit organization, and this is important. We're trying to leverage the e-health to be able to share. MedSync is an organization that's working with the folks at GHA, the Global Health Alliance, to support their services within a Web2O platform through a social network. It allows the exchange of information, discussion of various types of cases. It's a virtual clinical tool. If you're familiar with YouTube, you would be familiar with this concept. It's a way to exchange images, as well as video, as well as comments on a variety of types of sessions. And I just pulled up a couple of examples of how that information can be exchanged through this MedSync platform. Again, the social network of way to share information amongst the clinicians that might exist in your environment may be a very important tool, HIT tool, that you might actually want to use within your organization. An e-health approach within Web2O, within the social networking, would encompass a variety of different types of initiatives, whether it's the social networking that would occur, discussion on a case, whether it's personal health records where individual consumers can actually access, whether it's peer-to-peer networks that are set up between clinicians to talk about different cases or to exchange information. There are a variety of organizations in the US and around the world that work in these types of initiatives. Let me talk a little bit about clinical adoption, because you're not going to be successful in health IT unless you address the issue of adoption. I've witnessed many failed health IT initiatives because of the failure to engage the individual physicians and nurses and others that are using the system. In the US, HIMSS Analytics has developed this model to address the different stages of HIT adoption. In this case, we're dealing with electronic medical records. And as you can see, even in looking at a Q2, we have a very long way to go in the US to have complete electronic medical records with clinical decision support, data warehousing, and things like that. This is a very difficult process. But you're not going to be able to move up these stages unless you involve the clinicians and get them involved. To secure clinical adoption, you have to understand one particular thing that's incredibly important to physicians, which is their workflow. How is it going to impact their care? How is it going to impact the quality of care that they deliver? How is it going to impact their costs associated with providing the care? How is it going to impact their efficiency, their time to obtain information? How long is the encounter? How long is it going to take to enter the information and record the findings? Also, the physicians, particularly in the US, but I think all around the world, think about if they engage health IT, will it keep them in the office longer than they normally are there? And will they be unable to be home to have dinner with their children or to go out or other things that they need to do? It's part of a work-life balance in an environment. So workflow is incredibly important. It impacts the quality of care, and it impacts the cost, but it impacts the physician's personal time. If you want to be effective in using health IT, you have to pay attention to the whole concept around clinical processes and workflow, and measure them in these types of environments. Well, what drives adoption? Transfer to really the nurse and the physician asking the same questions that was initially asked is not a really good way to do a process. It is quite inefficient, and also creates an environment where there can be errors. What you want to be able to do is you want to streamline your processes so that every single thing that you do provides some level of value, and you document the value associated with it. The concept of path innovation is taking the going from a current state to a future state in terms of your process, but doing it in a way that you can enhance it. What I mean by this is that oftentimes when people look at clinical processes, they bring in, and they want to use IT, they'll bring in the physicians, and then they bring in the process re-engineering people, and then they bring in the IT people. And that works okay. But if you took the time within that committee and had the IT people educate the process re-engineering people and the clinicians what the IT can do, and the process re-engineering people educated the IT people and the clinicians about the importance of process engineering and how that works. And lastly, the clinicians educated the other two, the IT person and the process engineering person, a bit about clinical medicine. By doing that, you take a group of people who normally would look at the world with blinders on to understand what the other people do, to do two things. One is they can ask intelligent questions and additionally come up with new ideas about how to do things. For example, if I wanted to get from one city to another and I didn't know airplanes existed and they were 600 miles apart, the only way I think of getting there was driving, walking, biking, or taking a horse. But if you told me that airplanes existed, I could think, well, maybe I could fly there. I know that sounds a bit silly, but you probably don't remember the fact that if you don't know that things exist, you can't think of them as being a solution. That's what path innovation tries to do. It takes the re-engineering of those processes, but does it through cross-training and teamwork with the people that are involved.